Okay, amazing artists. Today, what we're gonna do is I'm gonna show you guys how to make like a little pop-up house just like this. And how it works is this way, you guys will be able to design the outside of your dream house, and you guys can go ahead and go to the inside and decorate the inside too. Now, we didn't see the inside of Mr. Plumbean's house, but we did see the outside. What you're gonna need in order to complete this activity for option two is you guys are gonna need a few different pieces of paper. The first one is going to be your background paper. I chose a blue piece of paper because I want you guys to be able to see the white paper on top when we're folding, but you do not have to have a blue piece of paper. It can be a white paper or a different color. It is up to you, just a piece of paper for the background. The next thing you're gonna need is two rectangles. One is going to be a small rectangle. The second one is going to be a longer rectangle. Now, how did I get these papers? I just started with a normal sheet of white paper. And then on this one, I went ahead and made a vertical cut down to get this long rectangle. And for this shorter one, I just went ahead and on a separate piece of white paper, I just made a horizontal cut across to get the top. That's all you need to do. So, one background paper, one small rectangle, and one large rectangle piece of paper. The first thing we're gonna do is start with our long rectangle. We're gonna make the body of the house or the main part. To do this, I want you to go ahead and take your pointer finger and find the center of your paper. Once you've found the center of your paper, I want you to find the side of your paper. And I want you to go ahead and fold that side of your paper into the middle of your paper, just like that. Then make that fold. Go ahead and switch fingers. Go to the other side and do the same thing, taking the edge of that paper and folding it into the center of the paper, just like this. All right. What we've done is we've gone ahead and folded the edges into the middle, and we have gone from a rectangle to a square. So we went from a rectangle to a square. Now that I have this fold, I'm going to go ahead and set it aside, and I'm going to get my small rectangle. For my small rectangle, what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead to the top of my paper and find the very center on the top of my paper. Next, I'm going to go to the far right corner, right up here, and I'm going to fold this corner down so the edge of the fold touches where my finger is, just like this. So I took that paper and folded it into the center, just like that, and made that fold. Now I'm going to switch fingers, go to the other side, do the same thing, fold it in, and make that fold. So mine was not perfectly in the middle, but you can go ahead and cut this bottom part off so you don't see that there. You also don't need this part here. So I'm gonna go ahead, get a pair of scissors, and I'm just gonna go ahead and cut that off. And there we go. So now what we have is we have gone from a rectangle to a triangle. So from a rectangle to a triangle, just like that. So now I have a triangle and I have a square. All right, these are gonna be the main points of the house. The next thing you're gonna need is you're gonna need some glue. This can be a glue stick, a glue bottle, whatever you need, but you are going to be needing to glue it. So I'm gonna take this part, I'm gonna flip it over so it's the side that's not folded, and I'm gonna go ahead and use my glue stick. I roll it up just like chapstick, just a little bit. And I'm gonna go over the edges. There we go. Now, if it's a larger shape, you can always do a little bit in the middle, but you never need to go over the whole side. You don't need to do the whole back. Now I'm gonna take this, I'm gonna flip it over. I'm gonna line mine up to the bottom of my background paper, but that's just my preference. And I'm gonna go ahead and place it on top, just like that. Now I'm gonna open up those doors and I'm gonna massage that paper lucky. As I rub that glue and those pieces of papers together like an Oreo cookie. And I'm gonna fold those back up. Now I'm gonna go up to the top triangle, flip it over, and we're gonna do the same thing. Add a little bit of the glue on the edges. Flip it over. Open it up. Massage those papers together. Then fold them back down. All right, next what we're gonna do is we're gonna look at the whole paper together. We have the top, so we have the roof of the house, and we have the bottom, so we have the body of the house. We know that they open up because we're gonna wanna see the inside too. But right now I want you to focus on the outside. I'm gonna go ahead and get something to draw. It can be a pencil, it can be a crayon, it can be a marker, color pencil, Sharpie, whatever you want it to be. I'm gonna use a Sharpie so you guys can see. And I'm gonna start adding my details on the outside. For your details, things you might wanna consider is having a door or some way to get into your house. I know in the book, Mr. Plum Beans, he doesn't really have a door on the front of his, but you can add one if you want one on your house. And then maybe even some windows. So go ahead and think about where you might want your door. You don't need to copy where my door is. Remember to add a door handle. I'm gonna even add a little bit around the edges to show a frame, but that's up to me. That's my choice, not you. You guys can add what you guys want. And I'm gonna go ahead and add some different windows. When you're doing windows, you guys can think about different types of shapes, different types of ways to use lines. Go ahead and go through. Maybe you want some curtains and draw all those cool windows and details. All right, now that I'm done with the body of the house, I'm gonna go up to the top. I'm gonna even add a window up here. I'm gonna make it like an attic, like it's 2 or 3 stories tall. I'm gonna make it a really big house. But if you guys want a window on the top, that is completely up to you. This is your dream house. All right, now that I have the outside drawn, I'm gonna go ahead and open it up. And for the inside, all I'm gonna do is I'm gonna add a horizontal line across my paper. And then I'm gonna add another horizontal line right below it. And then I'm gonna add a vertical line up here. The reason I added these lines, you do not need to add these lines, is because I wanna show the different levels of the house, the different rooms. So I have a room down here when you walk in, a room up here, a room over here, a room up here. And again, what you draw inside is up to you because it's your dream house. Go ahead and close it up. All right, so when you guys start decorating, I want you guys to use any types of colors, any kind of details you wanna add. You could add stripes, you could add stars, you could turn it into a cat house, a dog house. It's